Religious freedom is not just for adults. This is the CitizenLink Report. Hi, I'm Kim Troby. Well, in the news this week, an Iowa school and two North Dakota schools are coming under fire for allegedly not allowing pro-life student groups to be formed. But that's not the only thing that's facing kids in our public schools today. Imagine this storyline. A high school student and some friends start talking during free time about politics. That moves them to begin praying about cultural issues. For 3 years, they get together and their ranks grow to 70 students. Then suddenly, the school says they can no longer meet because of the so-called separation of church and state. Well, Bruce Houseconnect with Focus on the Family joins me today to talk about the case of Chase Windebank. Bruce, it's always good to have you here.
Hi, Kim. Thanks for having me.
Well, tell us first of all, is the school correct in its assessment that this is a separation of church and state issue?
No, they're not even close. This is a case of both speech and religious liberty combined. And in this day and age, it's almost amazing to hear that the administrators of a public school do not know the basic guidelines for speech and freedom of religion at the school. The federal Department of Education issues guidelines. They're available to anyone online. They have been for years, about this basic right that Chase and his group have to, if other students are provided the same opportunity for speech and gathering together, then a religious group has that right too.
And what makes this case particularly interesting is that it took place during free time during the day, and they should be able to do what they want during that time, right?
Well, and that's the big issue, because obviously, if it was during class time, a history class, for instance, you can't just start talking about something that's not relevant to the history course. But if you have free time where students can do everything from go to the snack machine to texting their friends on their phone to gathering in small groups to talking, then at that point, you have a First Amendment setting where people are allowed to do various things, including talk. But if you censor one portion of that speech and prohibit religious speech, that's a clear violation of the First Amendment.
Well, Matt Sharp of the Alliance Defending Freedom is representing Chase in a lawsuit. I was able to speak to him recently. Here's what he had to say.
So many students had grown to rely on and appreciate this free time that they had during the school day just to set their worries aside and just time in prayer and praise and worship, and having lost that now, there's really no way to replace it. Right now, we have filed what's called a request for a preliminary injunction. Basically, we're asking the court to order the school to allow these prayer gatherings to resume. We're waiting on a decision from the judge in it. We're hoping that the judge is going to rule in our favor. If not, then we'll decide whether we appeal or need to take other steps to defend our clients' rights.
Bruce, I mentioned the case in Iowa and two in North Dakota now. Are we going to be seeing more and more of these cases as the fight for religious freedom really moves to the forefront?
I think so. I had hoped that schools would kind of get the word, because these lawsuits come up, seems like, every couple of months. They get a lot of press, and we have the federal government on our side. The bureaucrats in Washington keep trying to tell the schools that students do have First Amendment rights when they cross that threshold into the school. So I'm afraid that the communication isn't getting across to schools. So we're going to have more of this in the future. And I'm afraid it seems to be getting worse instead of better.
All right. Your insights are always helpful. Thanks for being here today.
Thanks, Kim.
And thanks to all of you who have taken the time to write and share your thoughts and encouragement. You know, you can always let us know what you're thinking at mail@citizenlink.com. Please continue to pray for our public schools and for the students within them who just want to express their beliefs. And continue to pray for our elected officials and for our nation. And remember, stand tall and be heard.